One is a series of resilience standards where we're looking at how organizations are able to protect and create value within organizations and manage the risks of undesirable and disruptive events. And it's focused on essentially how you protect various assets. So we have a high-level management system standard that deals with organizational resilience. And in addition to that, we have a complementary standard that is looking at security management, where it's looking at physical asset protection, as well as a few weeks ago, we published a maturity model which helps organizations do a phased implementation of a resilience system within the organization to better protect it.
So organizational resilience, how well are you finding that that standard being received?
It's one of the standards that's involved in the PS PREP program. It was used as the base standard for the development of the ISO 28002 for the resilience in the supply chain. And it seems that it's being used by several organizations to both make the organizations more resilient, but also as a way of looking at how to protect their supply chains.
And I understand ASIS is working to getting these standards. Are they going to be reaching an ISO level standard?
Some of the standards have been introduced into ISO, and some of the standards are at the ANSI level, where they're still usable by any country in the world. And since ASIS works both at the national level as well as the regional level, for example, where we participate in CEN, which is the European standards body, as well as ISO, it's usually the route we take is where we can find the largest group of expertise to develop a standard, so it really represents the interests and the practical applications in the industry is the route we go. We're working on a series of standards that complements the Montreux Agreement and the International Code of Conduct for Private Security Service Providers, which laid out what is the code of conduct that security organizations that are providing services in regions of conflict and regions of weakened governments and disaster areas, how they need to conduct their business. So ASIS has led an effort of about 203 people from 25 countries and developed a standard for quality assurance of security services with respect for human rights. And that was just published. And in that, the addition to that standard in the series, we're also working on a conformity assessment standard for how a organization will be audited and certified that they're in conformance with the management system standard, and that was finished yesterday. And we're starting efforts on developing a maturity model for the quality assurance standard, as well as a guidance on how you apply the standard in the maritime environment for dealing with pirates and port security and other issues like that. ASIS is recognized as an international body and as a liaison member in both ISO and in CEN. And then in the U.S., we're a certified standards developer for ANSI. The U.S. usually lags behind other countries in the implementation of standards, but the 31,000 is somewhat of an exception because it is ISO's hottest selling standard, and it is also very well received by large supply chain companies who are using it as a framework for how they're going to manage risks both within their own organization as well as in their supply chain. Actually, ASIS is shifting most of the standards so they're consistent with the ISO 31000, looking at the perspective that the 31000 provides an excellent framework for managing a whole range of different types of risk, and things like security management and continuity management and physical asset protection all plug in very nicely to the framework that's outlined in the 31000. Before working at ASIS, which I've been doing now for about 6 years, I was involved with various projects both in the US and outside the US. I was looking at security management. I'm on the faculty at San Diego State University in their Homeland Security program. And actually, when I was at San Diego State, I started developing this concept of using systems approach for security management, and then was involved in developing the first security management system standards and pilot testing them in the United States as well as in Israel.
Really appreciate you coming on.